friends, welcome back to my channel. This month onwards, I'm going to start a new series called Back to Basics. I have been sharing many recipes on this channel. After about 50 recipes, I realized that we should also talk about some of the very basic recipes that we do on a day-to-day basis. It will be useful for many people, someone who cooks or someone who is learning to cook, and someone who wants to get a new method of cooking a basic recipe. So I think this will be an interesting idea. So what I'm going to do is every month, the last episode of the month is going to be back to basics. I'm going to kick off the series with the boiled potato sabzi, a classic recipe. It's a must learn for everybody. And I'm going to talk you through all the details of making this sabzi. Let's get started.
I start by washing the potatoes well and then pressure cooking them for 6 to 7 whistles so they are well cooked.
Now that the potatoes are boiled, I am going to peel the skin off. Make sure that the potatoes are not too hot and they are easy enough to handle. Now I am ready to cut the potatoes. Cut them in bite-sized pieces, the size that you like. Because they are already cooked, no need to worry about the size in which you cut them. Here I have some washed fresh coriander. A tip to make sure that you can cut the coriander finely is to absorb all the water using a kitchen towel. The drier it is, the better it will cut finely. Let's try it. Not bad, right? Next, we have some green chilies, which I want to cut into big pieces. You can add as many or as less number of chilies as you like. They give a, but use fresh green chilies because they give a great flavor. The last ingredient is curry leaves, which I have washed, and what I do is tear them into pieces to bring out the flavor. Yeah, I can really smell them. That's a tip right there. Don't cut them, tear them with hand. I have a non-stick kadai heating. When it is hot enough, I'm going to add about a tablespoon of oil. Once the oil is hot, I add about a teaspoon of mustard seeds, a teaspoon of turmeric powder to give it the signature color, and a pinch of hing. Next, I am going to add the green chilies and the curry leaves. Fry them in the oil for a minute. And now we are ready to add the potatoes. Very carefully add the potatoes. Make sure that you are not getting oil on your hand. It's a really hot oil. Salt to taste. If you want to know what this really means, check out my blog post. I will save a link for it in the description box. Give it a good mix. Making sure that there are no big lumps or chunks of potato in the mixture. Now it's time to cover and let it steam for 3 to 4 minutes. It's been about 5 minutes and it's time to check our potatoes. You hear the sizzle? That's what we are looking for. And see, the potatoes have taken a little bit of color. This is what is going to make this sabzi interesting and not flat. Okay. Last couple of ingredients and then we are done. Coriander that we chopped earlier and some fresh coconut. Give it a mix and let it cook again for 2 to 3 minutes and the bhaji will be ready. Ha, I wish you could smell this. Bhaji is ready and in a minute I'll show you how it is served in a nevedya thali. And here is how we typically serve a nevedya thali, starting with salt, lemon wedge, curd, amti, potato sabzi, steaming rice, dal, ghee or tuk, and some ukdi se modak with tuk to complete the naivedya.
This was my version of a simple potato sabzi called ukad patata bhaji, and I'm sure there are many variations of this. If you have one, do let me know in the comment section below. I would love to try it. As I said before, the back to basic episode will be the last episode every month. I have already selected the recipes that I'm going to share in this series, but if you have a special request that I should share in this series, do let me know and I'll be really happy to share that recipe. Thank you for watching, and if you haven't already, click that subscribe button and see you next time. Bye.